Hey guys, Cal Torak here. Today, I want to show you how I soloed Razorfin Downs for my Deathmage Sash. All things considered, it was a bit easier than I expected. I did have to put on some of the Eagle gear to replace some of my pieces that had no stamina. For talents, you want to be Deep Frost. This is the spec that I recommend, but what's important is you have Ice Barrier and Permafrost. For runes, we are using Living Bomb, Living Flame, Regeneration, Spell Power, and Spell Frost Bolt. I really like Spell Frost Bolt. Not only does it help with the healing, but its mana cost is very low. Really useful for finishing off mobs when you are low HP. There is nothing too fancy here, but if you aren't good at Kona Cold kiting, now is your time to get some practice. Almost all the pulls I do are handled this way. For pre-pull, I'll cast Ice Barrier and Regeneration on myself. Ideally, you want to then drink to full before pulling. Then I will begin to get Living Bomb on all the targets. If there is a caster, I will interrupt them to get them to stack with the melee. I will then cast Living Flame and begin the Kona Cold Kite. Refresh your Ice Barrier when you can, and reapply the Living Bombs as they fall. Make sure to be using Mana Jade on each pull. You will need the extra mana to secure the kills. The first few pulls are the hardest in my opinion, since you don't have much room to work with. Once you have cleared out the first area, you have an insane amount of kiting space to use. You'll see that I am often kiting slowly backwards, sometimes towards the entrance, constantly using line of sight to my advantage. There's nothing really fancy about any of the mobs here. The Death Heads Necromancers have a slow spell, but even that isn't that big of a deal. Just make sure you are trying to kill the casters first, because once they die, you can easily kite the melee mobs as long as needed. We are after the boss Mordesh Fireeye, and he's honestly really easy to kill. I started the pull by casting Living Bomb on him, Living Flame, and then Ice Blocking. My goal of this was to get all the adds stacked so they would die very quickly. Once the adds are dead, you want to kite him. I tried face tanking him, but his fireball was hitting pretty hard. There are a lot of good LOS spots you can use to dodge his fireball, and even then, towards the end of the fight, I just kept outraging his fireballs before they would go off, and slowly killed him with Living Bomb and Living Flame. You do want to be careful with getting in his melee range, as he does cast Blast Wave if you get too close. Really easy kill, and in general, was way easier than I thought it would be. Coming up, you will see a montage of the full run. I died only once, and that death was 100% avoidable. I was being greedy and lazy. If you found this video helpful, please like and subscribe. Take care, and best of luck getting your belts, boys.